Additive manufacturing is advancing the space industry. Thanks to additive, small companies can commercialize space. I recently spoke with Launcher. This small startup is working with EOS to build the components of an efficient launch vehicle for small satellites. I spoke with Max Hout of Launcher and Ankit Zaharan of EOS.
Why is additive manufacturing so crucial to realizing a small, cost-effective launch platform?
So the key to build an orbital launch vehicle is performance, and the key are the engine. You know, if you look at a rocket, it's mostly tanks, but if you look at the complexity and what really defines a rocket, it's its engines. In liquid rocket engine, you are basically to use your propellant effectively with the right, you know, fuel consumption and performance to reach orbit. You need to reach combustion temperature that are twice higher those of the, you know, some of the best metal we have, such as Inconel. The way to do that is you have to build internal cooling channels and do regenerative cooling and build some pretty lightweight, you know, nozzle and chamber where you run the kerosene through the nozzle wall to cool it so that you can have an internal combustion temperature twice higher than those of the melting point of your nozzle. Now, traditionally, these rocket nozzles with this internal intricate channel are very, very complicated and expensive to develop. The tooling required, the specialized craft, usually brazing, you know, machining and then brazing of an inner layer and an outer shell is required, doesn't allow startups to really get involved. So since the advance of 3D printing, in EOS here is our partner, you're now able to design the rocket engine with the cooling channel, the chamber and the nozzle, and you go straight from CAD to printing, and you're able to have all these internal geometries, and in our case, they're spiraling cooling channels.
Max was earlier hinting at how much challenges people have for a startup not having access to that capital expenditure, to be able to go through those million-dollar iterations waiting for those molds. And he did this 7 iteration in what, a couple of months, I guess. Like doing that in a traditional sense, I don't know, it would take years to actually do that thing, even if you're with big company. And from our side, we were able to kind of actually do that in a really fast way. We were able to go through a lot of iterations with them on the design challenges, especially with the cooling channels going on the side of the combustion channels, not only going straight through holes, but actually going spiral, which would be impossible to actually machine.
So we talk about the design freedom of additive manufacturing, and often when we say that, we think of geometric freedom, very intricate forms. You're describing a different kind of design freedom, which is a greater freedom to perfect your design by iterating very easily.
We're actually about to experiment, we've released that publicly, with a copper alloy. You were able to produce the exact same part in a different material to test. That's yet another advantage. That probably if we had developed a process for a given material. One of our objective or key objective at Launcher is to not only build a 3D printed engine, but build the highest performance in the market. So our goal is how can we, using additive manufacturing at a smaller size than this big engine, but can we reach similar performance, but at the cost of additive manufacturing? So one aspect of that is to push the highest combustion temperature and have the most effective cooling. And we are also R&Ding other materials such as copper before we lock down on a final decision.
Would you describe another component of the rocket for which additive manufacturing is important?
The next breakthrough is injectors. Injectors, right now we're using pinging style and we are transitioning to a coaxial injector. You know, an injector could have, you know, hundreds of different parts that have to be machined traditionally, QA'd, assembled, tested. You can now build an injector in a single part, and with geometries and passage and kind of even new ideas of how to distribute the flow before it reaches the chamber, of unprecedented creativity. You know, some of our designers don't necessarily even have the background of how it was done traditionally. They know what the end result need to be, and the freedom and the creativity that 3D printing gives allows these new type of injectors.